most of your Thanksgiving meal with Stop and Shop.
With over 30 years' experience, the law firm of Keith D. Silverstein and Associates has been winning multi-million dollar settlements for their clients. Whether it be a serious injury from construction, auto, or a slip and fall, you may be entitled to compensation. All initial consultations at Keith D. Silverstein and Associates are free and confidential. Se habla español. Call 1-866-I-WAS-HURT or send an email to info@kdslawfirm.com. Remember the name, Keith D. Silverstein and Associates, the injury attorneys.
Wins News at 7:55, something to make you smile today. Today, November 14th, is National Pickle Day. Give you some fun facts. The average American eats 9 pounds of pickles every single year. That's a lot of pickles, but they say that the majority of those that we consume come from hamburgers that are sold at fast food restaurants. You need to get those pickles on top there. That's where the majority of those 9 pounds come from. Michigan is the pickle capital of the United States. They make just under 250,000 tons of pickles every single year. If you are hungover, there is somewhat of a scientific cure that says drinking pickle juice can help you beat it. And yes, even pickles through history. Cleopatra, Queen of Egypt, credited her health and good looks to pickles. So see, give a little something to relish today as you learn about pickles. They are a pretty big deal. So semblance of normalcy this year as the 88th Rockefeller Center Christmas tree goes up. And while the schedule is up, the tree goes up. There are no details just yet on the rules for visiting. December 2nd will be the tree lighting, 35,000 lights adorning the 74-foot-tall, 11-ton Norway spruce. It was cut down from a residence in Oneonta earlier this week on top of a star made from Swarovski crystals. NBC will have that tree lighting on December 2nd at 7 p.m. But again, it's going up today. Wins News Time, 7:56. Now Bloomberg Money Watch.
The shift to electric vehicles could see a boost with a change in the White House. Bloomberg New Energy Finance has estimated EV sales could account for 25% of the U.S. market within 5 years under a Biden administration, though that assumed a Democratic-controlled Senate. Still, many established automakers had already been electrifying, no matter who's in charge. GM CEO Mary Barra.
We are 100% committed to EVs, and we're working to accelerate our EV transformation.
With electric versions of the Hummer, as well as the Cadillac Lyriq and a Chevrolet Bolt SUV, Volkswagen board chair Herbert Diess says they've developed a good relationship with the Trump administration. At the same time,
the Democratic program probably would be more aligned with our worldwide strategy, which is really to fight climate change.
Okay, now we're going to Springsboro Bridge, upper level.
Tennessee, months before the election was decided. Bloomberg Money Watch at 26 and 56 past every hour. I'm Nathan Hager for 1010 Wins.
I'm Dr. Andrea Russo, a cardiologist. Maybe you're waiting to talk to your doctor right now, but if you're having an irregular heartbeat, heart racing, chest pain, shortness of breath, fatigue, or lightheadedness, don't wait. This could be a serious condition like atrial fibrillation, which can make you about 5 times more likely to have a stroke. If you're having these symptoms, don't wait. Talk to a doctor by phone, online, or in person.
Brought to you by Bristol Myers Squibb and Pfizer.
CBS Monday. It's the season premiere of All Rise. LA's newest Superior Court judge is changing the system.
When I take the bench, I'm taking a vow to fight for justice.
One case at a time.
Your Honor, we're going to trial.
You're on this against Judge Lola Carmichael.
Up on that bench. Everything is different.
The season premiere of All Rise.
Freedom is at stake.
Boston Medical Group is offering up to $500 savings.